you guys are enjoying with the technology and you are able to implement whatever the things we learned so far, right? So before going to start the today's session, let me have a recall on whatever the things we discussed yesterday. So the very first thing we have seen about the formatting of our HTML, where the formatting, when we speak about formatting, we have seen 7 different elements and tags, right? So the very first thing we have seen about how to bold my text or how to bold my sentence or a paragraph, whatever I have mentioned in my website. So for that, we have used a tag saying B. B is nothing but bold. So in the screen, the humans, it is bolded, right? So this is done by tag saying bold. Okay. Then the second thing we have learned about italic font, how to get my italic font in my website. Okay. For that, we used a tag saying I. Okay. The first letter of italic I we have used as a tag to change the font of my website of a particular word. Okay. Here in the second line, I have highlighted impossible, which is displayed in italic font. Okay. This is the second thing we learned. Then the third one is about how to highlight a text or how to highlight a content, whatever we have displayed in my website. Okay. For this, we have used a tag saying mark, M-A-R-K, mark. So this is the tag where we used for highlighting a particular sentence or a text or the entire paragraph, whichever we need. Okay. Then the third one is about highlighting the sentence, right? Then the fourth one is about deletion. We have seen about del tag, D-E-L. So what it does in the fourth line, in the third line, the last word human is striked out, right? So this is possible by using the deletion tag, okay? D-E-L, delete, okay? Then the fifth one is about small, how to display a word into small format from the normal format or the normal font size, okay? And the fourth line, the healthy is very small letter while comparing with other words. Okay. This is what we have done by using small tag. Okay. Then the next one is about, so this is what about the formatting of HTML. So far we discussed yesterday. Then the next one is subscript and superscript. Okay. Subscript is used to display a particular word or a number in from the normal text to the base of the text. Okay. For example, I have written here a chemical formula saying H2O, right? For this, we have used a tag saying sub, S-U-B. Okay. Then the second one is superscript. Superscript, especially we are used in mathematical formula, whereas see in the next after H2O, we have mentioned A square, okay? Where the two will be displayed from A to little bit top position, right? So this is where we used a tag for to display this. We have used a tag saying superscript. The tag is S-U-P, okay? This is what about subscript and superscript. Then the next one, this is an attribute, okay? The subscript and superscript, we have discussed how to display in a particular paragraph or how to display in my web content. Okay. This is what about we have seen about yesterday. Then the next one is about reference, hypertext reference, how to give a reference in my website to refer some other pages. Okay. So that's what we have seen in the href tag. It is an attribute for a HTML. Okay. This is what we have seen in href tag. Okay, the next one is how to implement an image or how to get an image in my website. So this is what we have seen in using image tag. okay, IMG. Hope you guys remember IMG, then SRC. What is SRC here? From where I am going to display my image. Okay, this is what we have seen about this image tag and how to display an image in my website. Then the last two things is about how to display an audio and video in my website. So this is what we have done using for audio tag, then for video we have used video tag. Okay, so far these are all the things we have discussed yesterday. Okay, in the WhatsApp group I have seen few members were implemented in your local system and you have sent a screenshot test to all. Okay, just apart from this, guys who have stuck anywhere regarding all those things whatever we have discussed yesterday, please post in WhatsApp group so that I will be clear your doubts. Okay, so this is what the topics we have covered yesterday. So today we are going to the new topics. Okay, today we are going to discuss about two topics from HTML, and the second part is about CSS. Okay, yesterday actually we planned to cover the two topics also. Due to time concern, I'm not able to complete that. So today I'm going to discuss about those two topics, and the next part of the session will be about CSS, right? So the agenda for today's session is about, we are going to see about HTML tables. Okay, what is tables here? HTML tables, how to define a table. Okay, how to construct or how to build a table in my website. Okay, this is the first topic we are going to discuss about today. Then the second one is HTML list. Okay, we are going to discuss about what is a list and how to display a list in my website. Okay, then the second part of the session will be about CSS. What is CSS and what are the types and what are the rules to define a CSS? Okay, then the last one is internal CSS. So here internal CSS is nothing but it is the type of CSS. Okay, CSS is mentioned or segregated with three different types. Okay, in that we are going to see about one specific type today. Okay, so these are all the topics we are going to discuss about today. So if you guys noted clearly from the past two sessions, in that three types, I said we have three different types in CSS, right? You guys already learned a particular type of CSS today's session. Okay, I don't know whether you are going to accept this statement or not, but it is true. You guys learned already a specific type of CSS already. I will tell you, don't worry, I will tell you where you guys learned that type. Okay, so this is the agenda for this today's session. So as yesterday, just I am going to explain in the PPT what this means and how to use that. In the meanwhile, I'm going to demonstrate what I have explained here. Okay, hope you guys understand what we are going to discuss today. Okay, so the first topic, I'm moving to the first topic, HTML tables. Let's see what is HTML table. Okay, in general, what is a table means? It is consist of a rows and columns, right? What is a row? From left to right, it is called as a row. And what is a column? From top to bottom, it is about a column. Okay, just we are going to display a table in a row and column formats. Okay, this is what the ultimate goal behind this HTML table. Okay, so the next part is about what are all the tag we need to use to display a table. Okay, for that we are going to use about four different tags. One is tr tag. Okay, then the second one is th tag. Then the third one is td tag. And the final one is table tag. Okay, these are all the four different tags. Okay, we are going to use about to build a table. Okay, don't worry about it. Once I demonstrate the table, how to build a table in my website, I will be explaining what is this tr, th, td. Just I have mentioned the abbreviation forms. What is a table? row and what is the table header and what will be the table data. Okay, so this is what about the first topic we are going to see today. Okay, let me go to the demo. So I have created a file day4.html. So just I am giving a title as day 4. Okay, so first we are going to build a table. Okay, I'm coming to the body part of my HTML. Okay, as I said, we are going to use 4 different tags to represent a table in my website. Okay, the very first tag is about table. Okay, so what are we are going to build today? We are going to build a table. So for that, the first tag is called table. T-A-B-L-E. This is what the first tag. Okay, then the second tag, tr. So this is the second tag. What does this TRS actually means? It gives the row. Okay, what are all the rows and how the rows will be represented. Okay, this is what called as table row, and the tag to define a table row is called tr. T for table, R for row. Okay, so yesterday I said it, all the tags in HTML which will be very very easy and easy to understand and easy to remember also, because whatever we use a term like bold means the tag will be B, right? Like I want to make my word into small means the tag will be small, right? So similarly, whatever we are using in our daily life wordings, that will be converted into a tag in a simple format. Okay, so that is what about this HTML tags will be easily understandable to us. Okay, so we have seen about 2 different tags to represent a table. The first tag is table, then the second tag is tr. Okay, the third one is th. Okay, the third tag is about th. What is this th means? T for table, h for header. Okay, I am going to represent some headers in my table. What is this headers? If you noticed somewhere in Excel, we have some header parts, right? What we will do there, we will mention serial number, name, mobile, email number, and whatever the data we are going to collect from a user or from an organization, whatever. If for a contact person, from to contact a person, what all the details we will get? We will get a name from the person, the mobile number of the person, or an email, or if he is having any personal website, something like that, right? Like that, I'm going to add some headers to my website. For example, just I'm adding serial number. This will be the my first header. Okay. Then I'm adding another header saying name. Okay. Name. Again, I'm adding mobile or mobile number. Okay. Then the last one I'm going to use email. Okay. So this will be the headers for my table in my website. I'm going to display some name, mobile number, email. Okay. So what it means, a serial number, name, mobile number, email means, what we are going to display regarding this, whose name and mobile number, email ID. Okay. For example, take it as alphite.net. Okay, in my alphite.net website, I'm going to display who are all the tutors, okay, who are all the instructors in our organization, right? For that, we have to mention what is these details are, whose details those, okay? For that, just I'm using a tag saying caption, okay? Under table, I am using caption tag. What it means, it just represents what is this table is about, okay? What are all the details is mentioned in the table? Those details are actually what it means. Whose details are those? Okay, that's what we are going to mention in the caption. Okay, for example, I'm just mentioning as user details. Okay, guys, please listen carefully. Okay, do just see what I am doing, what are all the things I am doing to build a table. Okay, the very first thing, I have created a table tag. Okay, then I have created a row. Okay, my first row will be the header part of my table. Okay, for that I have created a tr tag. In that table row, I am specifying some headers. Okay, I'm using four different headers. One is serial number, second one is name, third one is mobile number, and the fourth one is email. Okay, to represent what this table is actually means, I am using a tag called caption. Similarly, we were using a title, headings in the document, paragraph tags, right? For a table, instead of heading, just we are using a caption here. Okay, for a table representation, we have to use only caption. Okay, this is what about the table creation and the header creation. Okay, let's run up to this what it is displaying there. Okay. See, in my output, I have got my user details, whatever the caption I have given and whatever the header parts I have given. Okay. When you type TH, table header, the default font size will be as displayed, and by default, the content will be bolded because the header part will be by default, it will display in a bold format. Okay. Now I got my caption. Okay. I have created my header parts in my table. Okay, what is next? So now I want to insert the datas here, right? To serial number, I want to display a data. For a name, I want to display. I want to display a mobile number. I want to display email, right? So how to do this? Okay, after this, just press enter. Now, I am going to create again TR. Why again TR? My first row is representing the header parts. Okay. Now I have mentioned what are all the headers. Now the second row will be the datas for the header, or for my header, I want to display the data. Okay. That will be the second and rest of the rows. Okay. How many rows? If you are going to display 10 contact details, means you can create 10 rows. Okay, for the demonstration purpose, I'm just going to add few contact details and let me show how to display that. Okay, header part is over, then the second point I'm going to add data. Okay, I have created another row. For this I am using a tag saying td. Okay, what is this td? T is table, d is data. TD is nothing but table data. For my table, I have created header. Then the second part is just for the created header, I'm going to display the data. Okay. The first data should match the serial number. It will automatically match the header. How? If you are giving four headers, means you should give four data. Okay. Then only it will replicate the same to the particular headers. Okay, so let's see how to display this. For displaying a data, I have created a tag td. So first, just I am giving inside the td tag one. Okay, this is my first serial number. Okay, then the second one is I am going to give another td. What is my second data? I should give name. Okay, for the header name, I should give a name. Okay, just I am giving my name Harish. Then the third one, okay, what is the third header? Mobile number. I want to give a number here. Just I'm giving 1 2 3 4 5 6 7. Okay, I have given a number here. Okay, what is the fourth header? Email. For the email, my data will be abc@gmail. Just I'm giving dummy data to demonstrate. Okay, see, my first row, I have created headers. Okay. My second row, I have given the data for my headers. Okay. Let's see what happens. See, for my headers, I have inserted the datas. Okay, the serial number, name, mobile number, email. Okay. So this is what about inserting a table and the row. So the meanwhile, you can add how many rows you want. Just I am copying the second row and then pasting. Okay, then I am giving serial number 2, and instead of Harish, I am giving some other name, like just I am giving Alphite. Mobile number is 12345. Okay, email is XYZ. Okay, this will be my third row. See, I got my second row, I mean the second data row. Let me add last data. Okay, this time I'm adding serial number as 3. Okay, see, this is all about how to insert a table in my website. Okay, if you notice, generally a table will consist of lines between each row and each columns, right? So I'm not getting this lines in each column and row. Okay, for that we need an attribute. Okay, where here the table tag is there. No, after this table, just give a space and type border. Okay, just border, type as border and click on enter. So it will gives you the borders of the table, whatever the headers you have given, whatever the table datas are available, it will give you the borders of your table. Okay, just for that, inside the open tag of table, give an attribute saying border. Okay, this will ensures you that your table is having with borders of each columns and rows. Okay, just I have saved the code. Let's see how it displays. See, superb, right? I got a beautiful table in my website. Okay, so this is all about how to displaying a table in my website. Okay, hope you guys understood this, how to display a table and how to display the headers and tables, rows, those things. Okay, so if you want to increase, see, if you want to increase the height and width of this table, means that is also possible. Already you guys learned about increasing the height and width, okay, for an image, audio, video. Yesterday I said you, right, how to increase the height and width of a particular image, audio, video. Similarly, for a table also, is it possible to increase a height and width, how much you needed? Okay, for that, just I'm adding another attribute saying width. Okay, sorry. How to display this? We are using an attribute saying style, right? Style, I'm just using width. Okay, and I'm giving 200 pixels. Okay, this is all about increasing the width and height of my table. Let's see what it happens after giving width 200. See, it increased, but it is not gives a that more changes from the existing width. Okay, let me increase some more. 400 pixels. See, it is increased, right? What happens if I give 600? See, the width of this table is increasing. For that, we are using an attribute called style. Inside the attribute style, I am just specifying the width. Okay, similarly, you can add height also. For that, just add height and then mention it as 300, just I'm mentioning as 300 pixels. Okay, let's see what happens. See, so Superb, right? So this is all about increasing the height and width of the table. Okay. Hope you guys are able to understand how to display the table in my website. Okay. So if you are not able to understand, please note what are the things you have in your mind to ask. Just note it down. At the end of the session, I will be clarifying your doubt. Okay. So let me recall once again. To display, our ultimate goal is to display a table in our website. Okay. For that, I have used a very first tag saying table. Okay. Then the second part, what I have done, I have given a caption. Okay. What this table is actually mean for. Okay. Just I have given a caption saying user details. Okay. In my table, I have created my first row. My first row of the table will be the header part. I have given four different headers using TH tag. Here T is nothing but table, H is nothing but headers. Okay. This header parts will be displayed in a bold format by default. Okay. I have used four different table headers saying serial number, name, mobile number, email. Okay. For the headers, I have added my datas, okay, with using table data tag, which is nothing but TD. Okay. I have added three different datas in my table. Okay. That's what it is displaying in my website or in my page. Then the last one we've seen about how to increase the height and width of my table using style attribute. Okay. Just by using style, I have mentioned a specific width and height, which is replicated in my site. Okay. Guys, hope you understand what is all the things about HTML tables. Okay. Then we are going to the today's second topic. Okay. The second topic is about HTML list. Okay. What is a list is about? We are listing some elements there in my website. For example, if you want to display some top 10 websites or top 10 code editors, top 10 top 10 richest person in our India or in our country, like that, right? We are going to specify in a list format. Few things I have given you as an example for your website. Whatever the list we are going to use, you can list it out using this list tag in HTML. Okay. In general, in HTML, we have two types of list. One is unordered HTML list. Then the second one is ordered HTML list. Okay. The difference between the ordered and unordered list, you can able to understand once I demonstrate in the coding part. Okay. What is this ordered list actually means? What is the unordered list actually means? Okay. The very first thing I am going to demonstrate you what this unordered HTML list will do. Okay. For unordered list, we are using a tag saying UL. U is nothing but unorder. L is nothing but list. Okay. Let's see how to use that. So just I am displaying here after the table itself. So what is the tag I said for unordered list? The tag is about UL. Okay. This will represent I am going to use an unordered list. Okay. What will be the unordered list? For this, I'm just adding a heading. Okay. Just I'm using H2. Unordered list for my website. Okay, this will be the header of my unordered list. Just I have given unordered list for my website. Okay, I have given header. Okay, I am going to use unordered list. For this, we are using a tag saying UL. Okay, I have represented UL. What is the next tag I said here? each list item starts with the li tag. Okay, for the list, whatever, if I am going to display five fruits name, okay, that will be listed one by one, right? That is what we are going to see the next about li tag. Okay, this will give you the what are all the list you are going to display in your website. Okay, the first I am just going to add a list apple. Okay, the second one will be again a line. I'm just displaying the fruits list there. Okay, then grapes. I have given my header just a modification, fruits by unorder list of my website. Okay, I am using unorder list and I have added a list of elements which to represent there. For that I am using a tag saying li list. Li is nothing but list. Okay, let's see what it happens. See, this is how an unordered list will be displayed in your website. Okay. Okay. The unordered list is nothing but the list items, whatever the list item we are used, that will be marked with the bulleting points. Okay. That will be marked in the bulleting points by default. Okay. This is the main functionality behind this ordered list of HTML. I will repeat you again. This unordered list will be marked with bullets by default. See, the small black circles are there, right? That is called as bullet. By default, if you use UL tag, which is nothing but unordered list tag, it will display like this. Okay. Then we will move on to the next type of HTML list, order HTML list. Okay, this is also very similar to that. Just I am copying those and I'm replicating here. Okay, the first part we seen about unorder list. The second part we are going to see about order list. How the order list will be displayed. For this, just I am removing un from the heading. Okay, for a unordered list, what will be the tag? An ordered list start with OL tag. O is nothing but ordered, L is nothing but list. Okay, just I'm removing U, replacing with O. The ending tag, just I'm removing U and adding. Let's see what happens. Okay guys, an ordered list I have represented here. I have clearly explained you what about this unordered list. The second one is ordered list. Okay, the tag for the ordered list is OL. To display the list of items, it may be unordered or a order, the list items will be displayed by using li tag. Li is nothing but list. This is the same tag where you can use an order list also. In the meanwhile, an order list also. Okay, I have represented in the coding. Let's see what it happens. See, now hope you guys able to understand what is the difference between ordered and unordered list of HTML. Okay, what this order list does here? An unordered list is displayed with the numbers by default. Okay, it will display in a order format, whereas bullet formats will not give us orders. But whereas this order list is giving you the order list 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, this is the main difference between order list and unordered list. Guys, hope you able to follow me and hope you can able to understand what I mean for ordered and unordered list. Okay, unordered list is nothing but the list will be marked with bullets by default. Okay, The ordered list is displayed with numbers by default. This is what about order and unordered list. Okay. So this is what about the HTML part. So far we have discussed about many tags and many functionalities in HTML. So up to this, I am ending the HTML part. Okay. Actually, we plan to discuss this about yesterday itself, but due to time concern, I am not able to do that. So today I have covered this HTML table and HTML list. Okay. So we'll move on to the CSS. Okay. So website development, we are going to discuss about two web technologies. So the very first one is about HTML. So up to this list part, I am going to end my HTML discussions. Okay. So let me recall you about the HTML and CSS. That day two itself I have mentioned. HTML is nothing but it is going to give a structure to my website with using some elements, tags and attributes. Okay, this is what we have done in HTML. Okay, we are moving to the next part of our session, is about CSS. Okay, what is this CSS? CSS is nothing but it will be the skin for my structure, or this HTML I said in a skeleton code, right? I have displayed you a skeleton image. That's what the HTML gives us. For that skeleton code, CSS will be the skin. Okay, where HTML give you the structural layer or a structure for my website. Okay, CSS will give you the presentation layer or styling part. It is how my website look and feel will be. Okay, look and feel will be how will. Okay, that is what about CSS. CSS is nothing but cascading style sheets. The abbreviation for CSS is cascading style sheets. Okay, this will be the presentation layer of my website or my web application. Okay, the main functionality behind this CSS is it is going to give a design. Okay, is going to give a design and how to display my HTML elements. Okay, we so far we have discussed lot of elements, attributes, tags and all, right? So this CSS will gives you how to represent the HTML elements. Okay, so we have three different types of CSS. Okay, what are those? The first one is inline CSS. Second one is internal CSS. Third one is external CSS. These are all the three different types of CSS we have. In that, today we are going to discuss internal CSS and the rest of the types, inline CSS, external CSS, tomorrow. Okay. In this three types, in the beginning itself, I told you guys already learned a particular CSS type. Okay, in this three, inline CSS, external CSS, internal CSS, you guys learned already. Okay, I will tell you where you learned, when you learned. Okay, so we'll start with internal CSS today. Okay, before that I will give you the syntax and what are the writing rules to represent a CSS. Okay, so this will be the writing rule of CSS. Okay, don't worry about the content and images. Let me explain you clearly what it actually means. Okay, a style sheet is made up of one or more style instructions. Okay, if you want to style, if you want to display the HTML elements in a different formats, means this style sheet will have a set of rules. Okay, set of rule or a set of rule set or as instructions. Okay, based on those we are going to design. Okay, we are going to style our website. Okay, this is what about the first point means. Okay, the last line in the first point is how the element should be displayed. Whatever the elements, whatever the tags we have displayed in the HTML, the CSS will gives you the instruction to how to display, how my content will be displayed. Okay, then the second one is each rule selects an element and declares how it looks. Okay, each element, we are going to select each element and we are going to represent how this will be look. Okay, so I said CSS is a set of rules or rule sets. The last point ensures a CSS rule set consists of a selector and a declaration block. Okay, that is what I have represented in the pictorial form. If you see in the right side, that will ensures you the declaration block. Okay, what it happens, there is having a selector inside the curly braces. We have a declaration part. What is the declaration part is about? There it will be having a property and the value for that particular property. Okay, first declaration is about we are going to use a single property. Okay, if you are using a multiple property for a single block, means it is called as declaration block. Okay, if you guys don't understand this writing rules, means don't worry about us. While I'm showing you the demo, I will clearly explain you what is this selector, what is this property, what is this value. Okay, what is this declaration block actually means, and what is the declaration actually means. Okay, I will differentiate both and I will explain you in the demonstration. Okay, as I said, we are going to see about internal CSS today. Okay, how to use this internal CSS. Okay, let me go to the coding editor and I will show you the demo. Okay, as I said, first we are going to see about internal CSS. What is this internal CSS and how to use that internal CSS? See, internal CSS is nothing but we are giving the styling properties in the header part. Okay, in the header part, we are going to specify some properties to style my web document. Okay, how? See, in up to HTML, we saw in the header part, the type, it consists about title. Okay, the rest of the web documents or what are the contents will be displayed in the body part, right? Whereas the CSS will be represented in the header part. Okay, CSS will be represented in the header part. Okay, for that, just click enter after this title. Okay, what I'm going to use, I'm going to use a style. Okay, style sheet. Okay, in that style sheet, the first style sheet is about internal CSS. For that, I'm using a tag saying style. Okay, style. Okay, I'm giving style. So when you see this document, the style tag, I'm going to explain you about this first declaration. See, what is the first? There will be a selector and a property and a value. Okay, let's see that. So what is the next thing I said here? In the first point, that describe how an element or group of element should be displayed. Okay, in HTML, what is an element? The word, whatever we use under a tag, open and close tag, right? The element is nothing but, see, let me show you here. See, P is the tag, right? Header is the tag and okay, two is enough right now. Okay, here P is a tag which represents paragraph, right? Here what is P? P is an element of a tag, right? P is an element for a tag, right? Just I am giving the element here, P. Okay, just I am giving P. After that, I am going to give a open and close curly braces. Okay, I'm going to use an element saying P. Okay, see here the P is nothing but selector. Okay, P is nothing but selector. Okay, P is the selector here. What is the selector? The selector will be the HTML element. Then the second one is, what is the second one here? It should have a property and value. What is property? For paragraph element, I'm using a property saying font family. Okay, I'm just giving the first one. Okay, then second one I'm giving as font size. Okay, the second one is about font size. Just I'm giving 20 pixels. See, if you notice this declaration part, first one, there will be a selector defining a style. Okay, the selector is nothing but an HTML element. I am used P, HTML element P, I am used as a selector. Okay, what is the second one? Property. There should have a property and a value for the property. Here, what is the property? I'm giving font family, and the value for the font family is, this is the one. This is the value for this property. This is what? Declaration of CSS. What is declaration block here? If you have in multiple number of property and values is called declaration block. What I have used here? I have used declaration block. Okay, if I use only font family, okay, one selector, one property and one value, this is declaration. Okay, if you have multiple property and value, then it is called as declaration block. This have a set of block. Okay, sir, you have said what is CSS and how to declare those things, right? How it will replicate in my website? Okay, how this will replicate in my system? Let's see. Let me just refresh my screen. What it happens? See, nothing has happened. Okay, I have represented a style for my website, but whatever the color I have given there, I'm sorry, whatever the font family I have given, whatever the size I have given, that is not at all replicated in my screen. Why? It's all about, I have represented this styles, for an element P. Okay, it will replicate only my paragraph tag. Okay, oh, guys, hope you are able to understand. This style properties and values I have given only for paragraph tag or only for P element. Okay, let's see. Let me create a paragraph here. Lorem I have given. Okay, my website is having a paragraph tag. For my paragraph, I have given a style here. Okay, So now I have added a paragraph here. Let's see what it happens. See, I have added a paragraph. Did you notice whatever the style property I have given for paragraph, the font family, the font size are replicated there. Okay, let me change the property and I will show you. Just I'm just giving 50 pixels there. Let's see. See, that is replicated, right? So what is this functionalities means? Wherever you use paragraph tag, okay, in your web page, see, I have used paragraph style here, an element for paragraph element I have used here. I have given a font family and size. Okay, in this particular page, wherever you use this paragraph tag, the style property will get from this. Okay, wherever you use a paragraph in this particular sheet, that style property will replicated based on the top thing, this style tag. Okay, see, next I'm giving another paragraph. Today topic is about CSS. Okay, again I have given a second paragraph tag here. For this also it will take the property and the value which I have given in the top. Okay, hope you guys understood what is this internal CSS. Internal CSS, the style property which you have used under the header part is nothing but internal CSS. This internal CSS is replicated only for element of an tag or element of a HTML tag or element of a tag, particular tag. Okay, where I have declared a paragraph tag here, for that paragraph tag P is my element, for that P I have given my style properties. Okay, how many times you may use paragraph in this particular page? That will replicate the style property of what you have mentioned in the style tag. Okay, similarly we can use this for header and the body part also. Okay, let me move on to the next one. For the next element I am going to use, for paragraph element I have used styles. Okay, next we'll move on to the next element. Just I am using H1. Okay, next I'm going to use H1 element. What is this H1 element? It is nothing but H1 is about headings. Okay, for this heading I'm just giving text align. All the font family, font size, text align, all the things we have discussed in the second day itself. Okay, second day itself we have discussed about what this font family does, what this font size does, and what the text align right now I have mentioned there. Okay, see, just watch what I am doing here. I have given a second element H1. For that H1 element, H1 is an element which is nothing but a selector for a CSS. Okay, H1 is element for HTML tag, whereas H1 is a selector for CSS. Okay, now I have used text-align :center. Okay, what happens? Wherever you use H1 tag in this particular page, that will replicated in the center position of your website. Okay, let's see. See, already I have used H2. Okay, but I have mentioned here H1. Let us rename to H2. Okay, The existing one itself I'm doing, okay, H2 already we used for ordered list and unordered list headings, right? Just I am renamed to H2. Let's see, it is replicated. What I have property mentioned, I have mentioned a property text align. What is the value of that text property? It is center. Let's see that H2 tag, whatever we have mentioned in the body tab, it is replicated in the center part of the screen. See, superb, right? It is replicated in the middle or the center position of the page. Okay. So this is what the next element. Okay. So what will be the next element? We have used paragraph H2. Similarly, you can use here up to H1 to H6. Okay. H1 to H6, you can use here. So wherever you want the specified property you want to replicate, wherever you use that particular tag inside this page, the styling property will be replicated only as you mentioned here. Okay. The third one is, let me use body element. Okay. Body element. What is this? This body part, okay, whatever we have mentioned under this body tag, that is what displayed in my web page, right? Just I'm adding a body selector in this. I'm just changing, I'm trying to change the background color of my body. Okay, just I'm changing the background color of my body. Okay, just I'm giving as aqua. What happens? Anyway, we are going to use body tag. Without body tag, HTML document contents will not display. Okay, for this body tag, I am using a background color saying aqua. If I am used a body tag here, the content whatever you have mentioned in this body tag, that background color will be changed into aqua. Okay, let's see it is replicated there or not. See, this is what replicated here. Okay, similarly, if you want to change the color, you can directly go here and change whatever color you want. I'm just selecting yellow green. Let's see. See, it is replicated in yellow green. So similarly, if you want yellow, it is displayed in yellow, the body portion. Okay. So this is what about the internal CSS. Internal CSS is a type of CSS, whereas internal CSS is defined or specified in the header part of my HTML document. Okay. Internal CSS is consist of what? Elements and property value. What is element? Element is nothing but whatever the word we have used in open and close tag, that is called as element. Whereas in CSS, the element is renamed as selector. For which selector I am going to use a particular property and a value. I have used paragraph and headings and the body element. Okay. So what this paragraph does, I have mentioned a selector P and I have given the property and value. So wherever you use the P tag in your particular page, the styles will be replicated what you have mentioned in the style tag. Okay. Similarly, like H2. Like H2 is nothing but a heading. It is used to display the heading. The element I have used here is H2. I have aligned into center. Similarly, wherever you use this H2 tag in your HTML document, that will be aligned in the center. Similarly, in the body portion also. Okay, this is what about internal CSS. Hope you guys able to understand what is this CSS and what is the functionality of CSS, and in that we have discussed about one type of CSS today. Okay. Hope you guys able to understand what is exactly. Okay. Here we'll end my session. Up to this, we'll end my today's session.